in this lecture, we will look into what is called performance of virtual memory. In the earlier lecture, I have shown you, we have discussed how virtual memory is implemented. Now, in today's lecture, we will see the performance of virtual memory, and the first performance issue that we are going to start our discussion with is called effective memory access time. That means, what is the impact of paging or the page fault in this implementation. Now, again, I am summarizingly discussing the virtual memory concept. Remember, we said that running program will generate the virtual address. Using the virtual address, we divide that into page number and offset. Using page number, we index into page table. It may lead to either page hit, page is found in memory, or it may lead to page fault. Page fault implies the page is not present. Remember earlier I said by looking into valid invalid bit of the page table, one can know whether the page is present in memory or page is not present. If the valid invalid bit is 1, it means the page is present. If the valid invalid bit is 0, it means the page is not present. Present in memory is not present in memory. So if it is not present in memory, if you remember I said the operating system will have to get the page from the disk. Right, it will load the page into memory, maybe by saving some of the page. We discussed this all this in this. So, in doing this page fault service, what impact it is going to create in the performance of virtual memory, we need to discuss. So that we are going to look into today's lecture. So for that, I will assume some parameters. Suppose, for example, I say main memory access time. Main memory access time. That means the time needed to access memory is some unit, let us say m, 100 nanoseconds, 200 nanoseconds, or maybe 100 microseconds or something like that. Now, when a page fault occurs, the operating system will have to bring the page into memory from disk. So that also will take some time. We will call that time as page fault service time. Okay, page fault service time. Now, for simplicity, we will indicate this as PFST, page fault service time. Likewise, we will call this memory access time as MMAT, main memory access time, MMAT. This we call it as page fault service time. Let us indicate by S. Generally, the disk access, the page fault service time access will involve disk access. So, generally, the disk access will be slow access. So, the value of S will be much greater than M. And moreover, we will assume page fault ratio. Page fault rate or page fault ratio will denote it by P. That means how many page faults are occurring for a given set of references. Then what will be page hit ratio from here? Page hit ratio or page hit rate. Remember, this value of P will be in the scale of 0 to 1. So therefore, this will become 1 minus P. Meaning, this problem is just like our TLB in which we discussed in the class. Same thing, something like that. So what does this mean? This means that if the page fault rate is 10%, then page hit ratio will be 90%. If this is 50%, this will also be 50%, 0.5, 0.5, like that. Then the question is, what is effective memory access time? We will call it as denoted by EMAT. This is given by a formula which you have to remember. Page fault rate P into service time S. For page fault rate P, service time, page fault service time, plus page hit ratio. This P is page fault rate. 1 minus P is what? Page hit ratio. Where is the hit? Hit is in memory. So this will be the equation, this will be the formula. Remember, this formula we have derived just like as we derived the similar formula with paging and TLB. So same. So you have to remember this piece. I am marking it as star. In the exam tomorrow, you may expect a problem on this. I am going to discuss one problem exactly based on this formula, and you have to use the same approach for solving the problem if it is asked in the exam. Okay. So based on this formula, I will solve this numerical question. So please pay attention, try to understand the question. Okay. We will define the question like this. In a virtual memory system, the time to service page fault, is seconds and or we will say 10 milliseconds, okay, 10 milliseconds and main memory access time, is 1 microsecond. Then for a 99.99% page hit ratio, calculate effective memory access time. Okay, it's a very straightforward question exactly based on the formula. Remember, I am showing the keeping the formula here, these are the parameters. So let's try to review. Okay, so pay attention please. What is given to us? Time to service page fault. Page fault service time is how much? 10 milliseconds. So here we will write page fault service time, this is equal to 10 milliseconds. Memory access time is given to be how much? Here it is given. Main memory access time. Look at this. Memory access time is 1 microsecond. 1 microsecond. Okay. Then what is this 99.99% hit ratio? Hit ratio is 1 minus P. 1 minus P is 99.99%. So convert from percent to the scale of 0 to 1. This will become how much, please? 0.9999. So therefore, what will P become? 1 minus this value, which is 0.0001. Got it? So very simple calculation. Okay, so based on the formula, please understand, based on the formula I have derived all the parameters. P is known, S is known, 1 minus P is known, M is known. So substitute the values in the formula and see what is effective memory access time. So let us substitute the value. Again I will write the formula for you. Effective memory access time is given by P into S plus 1 minus P into M. Alright. So all the values are there with you. You need to only substitute the values here. So what is P? P is this value. 0.0001 into what is S? Service time. Paid for service time is given to be how much? 10 milliseconds. So 10 into 10 power minus 3 seconds. Plus milli is 10 power minus 3. 1 minus P is 0.9999 into 1 microsecond, 1 into 10 power minus 6. Is it not? Now look at this. This is 10 power minus 4. 10 power minus 4 into 10, 10 power minus 3. 10 power minus 3 into 10 power minus 3, 10 power minus 6. So this whole factor will become 1 into 10 power minus 6 plus the 0.9999 into 10 power minus 6. Therefore, 10 power minus 6, 10 power minus 6 common. Here I have 1 and here I have this. So I add them together, 1.9999 into 10 power minus 6 seconds, which can be written as 1.9999 microseconds. 10 power minus 6 is micro, which roughly you can say 2 microseconds. Got it? This is the answer. So therefore, this is how, using the formula, you substituting in the equation, you will get the answer. So tomorrow in the exam, they may ask you question on this aspect, like based on this formula. So please conceptualize the formula, remember it very well, understand it very well. You may be given a numerical question for 5 marks and you will have to work out in this fashion. Okay, good. So this is the first aspect of performance of virtual memory. In the next lecture, we will see other performance. All right.